Now the last project which is missing, which I promise, is for the system workbench for STM32 from the AC6 company. Then I will select the SW for STM32 and I again click on the OK, and we can generate the source codes. Now here we don't have any option to open directly the file. We need first to open the system workbench and then we import our project. We click on the close and I will open my project manually. Now I'm starting with the system workbench. Then first I need to select the workspace. Again, I will select my workspace to the same position when I have my project. Sorry, too many projects. I select here the cube, my example projects, and the same place where is my project for the system workbench. Okay, and I open my project. Now my system workbench has started. I here again close the welcome tab, like in the Atolic. You can see I have no project here. Then we need first to import our project. Then I here go into menu file. I here select the import. And I need to select the type of the project. I have the existing project and I wanted to put it into my workspace. Here you need to search for your project. Then I will try here the set here my project which I generated. I select it. He only informed me that this project is on the same place as my workspace. It's okay. And I will click on the finish. You can see here is also the path to my project. I will click on the finish. Now we can check. Again, we have here the main.c. We need to open the application, the user, the main.c, like in the Kyle, IR or Atolic. And we here put the same part. We will toggle with the LED. Oh, sorry. Yes, I start with the HL underscore GPIO underscore toggle pin. Again, the pin is GPIO A. Oh, sorry. Then GPIO. Pin underscore 5. This is the number of pin. And I put here also delay, because otherwise the toggling will be not visible on, I think, 16 megahertz will be not possible to see it. Okay, this is enough for my first testing code. It's very simple. We will go through this all commands during the next sections. Now we build the code here with the button build. Expect that everything will be okay. Yes, I can check here in the console that build is finished. No problems was reported. Otherwise, I will end up with some error and I will get the list of my errors, what I need to correct if I have some mistakes in my code. But now everything is okay. Then I need again to set up more things, not only one. In the run, I need to go to the debug configuration. I here need to double click on the AC6. Sorry. Here is the window. He asking me to select the board. I can use the new board if I want, or I can use the old one. We can start, for example, from scratch. Then I start with the new board. You need to select the debugging interface. I have the on the Nuclo ST-Link version 2.1, and my debugging interface is SWD. Then I define new board. Click on the OK. You can see now my debug configuration was created. It's OK. I check here the debugger. Everything seems OK. The startup is connect under asset. It will immediately halt the processor. Then it seems everything is OK. Then I click on the apply. And I here can click on the debug. And he will start for me the debugging. He also asking to save my resources. If everything is okay, then he launch for me the debug interface and switch the view from the editor to debugger view. Then here is one slightly small problem. It seems that it's in my laptop when the OpenOCD doesn't like my USB 3.0 ports. And I try to switch the interface. Then I start here again. And here I can use this button, and I use the last configuration. Yes, I want to switch to the debugger perspective. Again, you can see I'm on the beginning of my main, and it's very similar to Atolic. I can with this button run the debugging, with this stop the debugging, with this button I can stop the debugging, and with this button I can terminate and leave the debugger. I will run my code. On my side the LED is blinking, then everything is okay. In case you want, with this button you leave the debug. And here, with this, you need to switch the perspective back to the editor. Then don't forget on this part. Then this is everything from how to run your first code in the System Workbench.